Yes, you first, second.
You teased us a little bit toward the end about thinking about what was the universe doing before it was expanding. Now, the conventional answer is that you can't ask that question, but it seems like your teasing has invited us to ask that question, and we've been hearing a bit in recent times about a less dismissive answer to that question. So would you care to elaborate a little bit?
Perhaps you're thinking of inflation?
I'm thinking about before the Big Bang.
Yes, well was there a before?
Yeah,
Stephen has
right, exactly.
Stephen has pointed to the no boundary theory, very attractive, but alas, I have to be blunt and say no evidence, and no empirical evidence. It's, to my way of thinking, wonderful philosophy, it's wonderful physics, but it isn't a demonstration of reality. To me, the evolution of the universe back the last 10 orders of magnitude and expansion, back to light element production, is pretty firmly established. But theories of what happened earlier than that, and I presume there was an earlier, are much more difficult. Inflation is a standard theory for what happened before classical general relativity and conventional physics could have applied. Inflation has passed, I think, three remarkable tests. First, although it's heavily debated that inflation produces homogeneity, the early intuition was that it does, and that turned out to be correct. Second, the inflation, as an originally interpreted, gave us a set of initial conditions that match the theory very well. Again, it's debated whether inflation really produces these initial conditions or whether they're simply the simplest of all possibilities. It's still debated. Then mentioned also is polarization of this thermal radiation left from the early universe that would be produced, among other things, if there were gravitational waves produced by inflation. It's going to be tough to get at that one because radiation coming to us from the galaxy is also polarized, and untangling the two is a really complicated challenge, maybe never met. So we will have, if that not met, the horrible possibility that we will have a theory for the early universe that is debated and tested only by the two things I mentioned, neither of which can be considered a real theory, theoretical prediction. So we end up, just as we cannot explore all those fascinating planets on the next galaxy over, we need not be able to establish a theory of what happened before the universe was, say, 10 to the 10th degrees hot.
Rudolf Muradian, yeah?
You are a great specialist about rotation. We think your models were very popular, and because of this, I would like to propose to remember the proposition of two great members of our academy, the Lemaître and Sir Edmund Whittaker, about origin of rotation, which is different from your point of view. They proposed that rotation in universe originated from the rotating primeval atom. You're thinking about this possibility?
I'm not sure what you mean by rotation. Are you asking what does it mean to accelerate? What does it mean to rotate? To Einstein, just as motion is meaningful only relative to other objects, he certainly, with others, loved the idea that rotation is meaningful only relative to the rest of the universe. That's certainly true in part. The gyroscope experiment, going by the name of Gravity Probe B, showed that a gyroscope near Earth moves relative to the distant stars because the rotation of the Earth is dragging, so as to speak, inertial frames. Is that what you have in mind?
Yes, I have in mind something other. I think that the proposal of Lemaître about rotation, rotating atom, yes, must be substituted by rotating hadron. Hadron can have rotational angular momentum. In very specific quantum mechanical sense, in Rege 2 sense. And numerically, it gives very interesting, very exact predictions for all planets, stars, and galaxies. And maybe for universe also. I mean this. I will speak about this in my talk.
I am not familiar with it. Perhaps you can educate me later.
Any other question? Yes, Pagnato.
Okay, there is a delay between pushing and getting. My question is related to time. We learned that time starts with the Big Bang, and then you use time as a parameter so we can see the evolution after they start. But it seems that something happens before. So what is the equivalent parameter that you can use to understand the evolution before the origin of time?
Good. I emphasize again, the theory does not assert that the standard and accepted theory makes no assertion about a Big Bang. A bang, to me, connotes an event that is a well-defined time. It also connotes a well-defined position, an explosion. Both are wrong within the theory of general relativity as established. The theory, as established, describes the evolution of the universe from a dense state to the present, an evolution that is now well experimentally tested and confirmed. It makes no strong assertion about what happened earlier than the earliest experimental tests. The standard notion is something like eternal inflation, bits and pieces of the universe exploding up and making baby universes, big or small. But that's not part of the established theory. It would be good if we could abandon the words Big Bang, because they're totally misleading.
Just about, you said that if that exists, okay, we're going to take Big Bang out. But if the orange was in one point, no, it's everywhere.
It's everywhere.
Okay, well, that's... why we don't, you know, what's that inconsistent with overall start that I can call Big Bang? Why I have to take that out?
You are entitled entirely to talk about a Big Bang, that is to say, a start to everything. You're entitled. I notice that Georges Lemaître did not mention that in his Primeval Atom. He started with something that perhaps had a history. He didn't go into the history, but it's allowed. What you can't do is to say that we're all at a point, because we see the universe around us uniform everywhere. And so if we live in the multiverse, we live in a section of it that is very remarkably uniform, out to the greatest distances that we are allowed to see. Light traveling at the velocity of light and all that.
Okay.
You're entitled to think about earlier times. It's fascinating, but the limits of what we can measure and test are such that we can't say what's happening at arbitrarily early times.
Okay. Could I Maybe you have please. A last question before we move to the next speaker. You mentioned the mystery of dark matter. What is the direction of research or hypothesis that you personally feel possibly productive on this point?
It's fascinating that people have been looking for this dark matter since it was postulated in the early 1980s. Give us at least 30 years of research. It has detected nothing. Each year, the tests are more sensitive. People are not only deeply curious, they're also enormously tenacious, and honorable souls are working very hard to try to detect this radiation, either directly through its effect on sensitive detectors, or indirectly through the pious hope that some of this dark matter may decay and emit radiation that may be detected. These are all fascinating lines of research to follow. I support them totally. But I guess I wouldn't be amazed if the dark matter is simply not detectable aside from its gravity. We needn't be able to answer all questions.
A last question, Steve Shu.
It's a bit tongue-in-cheek, but to help Vandelay think about this, the experimental data is plotted on log in the scale of the universe, log in time. There is no origin.
So, thank you again for this. And I'm calling the next speaker, Robert Deichgraf, on the quantum universe.